Something happens to me, like I'm calling Chloe, but there's no response because
it's not going to work.
Our phone is just destroyed, and I'm like, shit, I need you right now. And I'm going to see Heritage.
Perfect. Well, that is fine because you are going to see something a little bit different than you expected.
Did I expect something?
Well, from what you had seen before. So in this strange little crypt or secret area where this is, what you will find is a completely different statue. The statue is a man standing. You have never seen him before. He looks like a young and well-fed, handsome French man. Perhaps a young business student or something like that. And it's a statue there. And you have the candle is not burning. It is out. And there is no ring or anyone else. At this very same moment, in the taxi cab, you are riding not with Chloe is not riding with Julian at all, but with her father, and your father begins to reassure you that no problem, we are getting to the airport in plenty of time.
Merde.
Dad, give me your phone.
He says, "Oh, it's okay. I just talked to your mom. She's fine."
Where is Julian?
He says, "Julian will be okay here in France. He's looking forward. He's buying a. He's getting a condominium for the two of you. Remember?"
Dad, just give me your phone, please. I just need to text someone.
Well, all right, listen. We need to keep a low profile. We can't have anything happening on these phones that could possibly catch the attention of the
bureau. Dad, give me your phone and shut up.
Make a will roll. Add one die. That was fun.
So it's will, right? No, mm-hmm. It's what?
Will plus one.
Ten?
Oh, well, no problem. In fact, I'm interested. How many dice do you have above five?
Four.
Okay. Your father very obediently gives you his phone.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. So I'm calling Livia.
Mm-hmm. So, Livia, do you carry a cell phone around with you all the time?
Yeah, almost all the time, yeah.
Okay. Well, it rings.
Hello?
Livia, it's Chloe.
I need you.
Me too. It was my boyfriend.
Yeah, I found
him. Yeah, that whole problem with why we're friends, that's over. We don't have that problem anymore.
No, I'm like looking at the statue and like, what does your boyfriend look like?
Well, he's like blonde.
That's not going to help.
And he's handsome. And he has a small scar there.
None of that is visible on the statue, of course. Do you want to show her a picture?
Oh, yeah, of course. I'm sending the picture. So tell me, because you're speaking, but so there's no candles anymore, that's it. The ring is still on the candle? No. And the ring is still there? Heritage is not contained anymore.
Okay.
And I have the police on my church.
Yeah, that's kind of my fault. I'm sorry. I will explain. Can we meet somewhere else? Like, I don't know, is your church safe now?
Well, come in the church. And I'm asking Epiphany, let Chloe in the church. Enter in the church.
Epiphany says is okay with this. Yes.
We need to find it. Epiphany, where is Heritage?
No, you were asking Epiphany this. Okay. Yeah. Well, you can perceive everything around and about and near your church. So all you have to do now is to roll your will to see if you can find Heritage, which is a very easy roll. So just roll your will.
6. 6.
Ah, you succeed. It was a very, very easy roll. So you and I rolled a 3. So that's okay. You have, you realize that exactly where the biggest service location was in the old church. You know, the big altar, the biggest crucifix in the biggest room. Adam is there. And he is wearing the ring, and he is completely naked, and he is very, very, very beautiful, even more beautiful than the statue. And he is holding his hand on his chest, the ring is on a finger, and he is repeating to himself. He's standing there where the crucifix had been, long, long, long lost, of course. And the whole area is glowing as if gold had been put into all of the little trim and decorations of that area. So there's glowing gold pieces and lines, and he is framed there, almost glowing himself because he is so beautiful with the ring on his finger on his chest. And he is saying over and over, Chloe, Chloe, Chloe.
So, okay. Come into church. I need you. Like right now.
So I'm going to ask my dad to drive us to the church.
That's going to take another will roll, but you're going to get 4 extra dice because of your previous victory.
Oh, jeez. Okay.
We're so fucked up.
Oh, my God, I'm not that good. 9.
What? How many 9s? 1? Okay, so then what is your next?
7s. 2 7s.
Okay, no, you win. Seven. Okay. He only has 1 7 and then something else. So your second 7 wins. So he argues a little bit.
Can't speak.
Yeah. But he but he will obey. And so he very reasonably, you know, tells you that that this is all about getting you into a safer situation, and that he doesn't want to know. Oh, you don't want to. I get it. Okay.
I'm not allowing him to speak.
I see. Okay. Well, so then we have. Let's see. Well, then I think I will let you two figure things out. Should you want to make any lore rolls, let me know.
Okay. before leaving the car, I'm feeding Dustin again, and I'm like, girl, I need you.
Okay, that's the last of all the little roly-polies that you took from the church.
Yeah, perfect. And then I'm going to the church.
Right. So this is actually a little bit amusing because you can just walk straight in through the main doors of the church, right through all the police and everything, and it's okay. Right. And then, you are sorcerer enough to know when you look, just by looking now, that you can see that Epiphany is going to let you in and this is not an issue. So you can just do the power sorcerer strut straight into the church. Yes.
Yeah, <you're> right.
Okay, so without waiting, I just explained you the scene that Adam is there.
Not even a hug.
And the statue of Julian, of course.
Oh, please.
Adam is there, controlled by Heritage, doing some world sorcery, asking for you.
For me?
So, I don't know how, but we need to banish this thing or anything.
We need to banish it. I need to talk with Adam. Do you think that Heritage could make Julian better? Like?
Yeah, sure. Let's go talk with Adam. Yeah, sure.
And he did it for Adam, so he could probably do it for Julian, right?
Yeah.
I'm not sure.
Lydia is probably considering whether decapitation isn't the best solution at this time.
Come on, it's my boyfriend. What would you do if it was Omar?
Don't do this. I'm getting angry. Like, don't talk about this.
About what?
But just come.
You're not the boss of me?
Your boyfriend is actually doing stuff.
Boyfriend, thank you.
I'm gonna eat you now. Okay.
I want to hear this in French. It would be much better in French, I think.
Allez, we can do it. Like, ta gueule, tu m'emmerdes. Je vais t'en mettre une. Je vais kick you. And I'm like getting angry.
I'm bullying you, it's fine. Just chill.
I'm chill.
You're not. Come on. I need you.
Stop hugging. We need to. I'm leaving. Come with me. And I'm leaving. I'm going to the room. But still. Okay. Okay. So I've seen the scene you described to me. And I want, like, I'm checking all the details in my mind, like, what's happening? What is he doing, actually, right now?
Well, for one thing, Henri has crawled to it and died. And has rotted almost immediately, like a week's worth of decay in just a minutes. And, of course, Adam is now standing in that mess and has rubbed it all over him and especially over the ring, and it's now burning and drying and flaking off of him as Heritage feeds.
Oh, shit. Stop arguing now.
I am following you.
Okay, and I want to go to this part of the church right now.
That's where, that's what you see there.
I'm scared.
Me too.
You want me to try that first?
Yes. Please.
Will you try to keep
me? Maybe, if you ask so.
Do you? You've known your whole life acting. You can do this. Adam!
And I'm keeping on the back, you know? I'm staying on the back.
Adam?
His eyes open. And you know that kind of look in Tetsuo's eyes and Akira?
Yeah. Jesus. Hi. You were asking for me?
He says, the perfect triangle. Father, husband, lover. In perfect balance, surrounding the perfect woman, the perfect voice, the perfect heart. We shall be the three, your three, forever. Even as the circle shall be complete and unbroken, once its imperfection has finally been erased. Kill her. Kill her, Chloe. Kill her for the perfect, perfect triangle and the perfect circle of gold.
I'm like so fucking angry now. Like,
it's perfect because she was going to be like looking at you. Like,
I don't know how to deal with this.
Livia, do you remember what happened when you touched the ring?
Yes.
It tainted you. It hit you really hard with a humanity reducing.
Yeah.
Blow that changed your behavior in ways that you don't like.
Yeah.
So,
okay.
Right. Adam smiles and says, of course, and holds out not the ring as if to give it to you, but his hand with the ring on it and says, it is yours after all. He's holding out his hands to Chloe in a very generous and loving holding come to me kind of way.
Don't touch the ring. Don't touch the ring.
No.
On second thought, keep it.
I don't know what you mean.